And thanks, hello, for that platform which is set. I have been told that, you know, I have only 15 minutes, but now I have been told it's only 10 minutes, and I have to talk about the future in 10 minutes. So, the slides are running already. So, looks like it's all IoT, it's running faster than me. So, just to go back a bit, I'll talk very briefly about our company. Kanavate, we started this company with a very clear vision to build IoT products. We built a platform for IoT, which is based on Bluetooth Low Energy, and we have an app layer and then the cloud layer, everything built end to end. The whole solution has been, I think the slides are running by themselves. The whole solution has been already in place from the last 1.5 years, and Gecko was one of the first products which we rolled out. And as a startup, you know, we were always wondering, how do I take it to the mass market and how do I make it known to the world? And crowdfunding was one of the ways which we took our path, and then we went on crowdfunding on Indiegogo. And thanks to some of the responses which we got from tech magazines and even Steve Wozniak, that we got successfully crowdfunded for 270% of the original target we had. So after that, it has been quite a nice story for us. Though we had our own ups and downs, we had very difficult times as a startup with the cash flow and everything. We have passed through all that, and now recently we got acquired by this company, Binatone. So we continue to be in the space of IoT. We continue to provide the solutions in the space of IoT. And one of the reason why Binatone got interested in us also is that because we have been building products for them for several years. I mean, I'm associated with them personally in different organizations for several years. And we have rolled out products which have become cash flow for them, cash cow for them for a couple of years already now. So coming back to IoT and future of IoT, so here we are talking about how IoT is helping and changing our lives. If you see, some time back, we used to look at the weather, or even today, look at the weather in your weather report, and then based on your timing, when you're coming back home, you set the thermostat manually and then go. But today things have changed. Nest is a very classic example everybody takes about it. Nest, they directly talk to the systems, and then they know what time, what is your schedule, they know when you left your office, and they know what's your comfort zone, and they actually set everything up automatically for you when you walk in. One other interesting area is retail. In retail today, if you walk in, you go for shopping, you typically take a list with you, and when you, as you enter, somebody will walk up to you and say, these are the offers we have today and stuff like that, and they give you a bunch of catalogs, and then you start going through it. Irrespective of whether it is relevant to you or not, it is still dumped to you. And many a times, even if it's relevant to you, you end up throwing them and then buying something else, which otherwise could have saved you some bucks, right? IoT is changing everything. By the time, in IoT, your smart home, your fridge is connected to the system, your grocery list is getting populated automatically. As you walk into the, say, Walmart or these superstores or any shopping mall, already the mobile comes up with your list, what you want to buy. And as you enter the mall, the shop already knows who has entered, what your spending habits are you a vegetarian? And based on your typical shopping list, it comes up with the list of recommendations, and also it guides you through the aisles depending on your list very quickly, so that you can finish your shopping very fast and come out. So that's going to change the way the shopping is happening. Okay, I'm giving up. So definitely, IoT brings in a lot of stuff, but we always had the content. But what is changing with IoT is the context. The context is making it all more meaningful. And context is the king. And what is context? Context is all about who, when, where, what. Okay. So we already know who we are. We are already telling what we are doing, where we are, through all the check-ins and stuff like that. And this is not going well. So then we are already now telling who we are, where we are, and our schedule is also known to most of the people whom it is relevant to. So when we are doing what, and a lot of this data is already available. But what is not available today is connecting the digital world to the physical world. And IoT is bringing that connect. IoT is making that happen. So basically, IoT is bringing the connection between the digital world and the physical world. So yeah, it's completely out of context. So this brings the connect between the digital and the physical world. So this is one slide which I would like to talk about. Is context is all about bringing that meaning into the system. So basically, there are sensors which are collecting the data, which is quantitative data, which tells your fridge is running out of milk, or your egg miner is telling that you're running out of eggs, stuff like that. And then there is qualitative data which also gets collected depending on the pattern of your lifestyle, what you are buying, where you are buying, how you are buying, stuff like that. And that's the knowledge which is built in the system. And using these two in IoT, the systems will take a very wise decision as what is relevant to you and how it can be brought to you, right? And secondly, I'll just jump to the next one. The tourism is a very very good example, where if you walk into suppose you are on a Europe tour and you walk into a museum, the museum guides do not have a context that you are coming from India and you do not know the history of that museum, whereas IoT is going to change all that. So imagine you walk in there, they already know that you are from India, you do not know the history of that particular museum. It brings you first the audio visuals about the museum and tells you little more history, brings you up to speed, and then you start walking in. And it also knows your profession, it knows your hobbies and interests. And depending on that, it tries to explain you some things little more than some things little less. It makes a totally a different tourism experience. So IoT is literally changing almost everything, be it tourism, be it travel, be it at home. You come up to your coffee desk and then automatically your favorite new channel comes up. Or you are tired, you come back home and you come on the couch and automatically on the TV, your favorite relaxing music and other channels come up. So those kind of things are going to happen. IoT is definitely changing the world. So this was one very interesting case study I wanted to say, if I can, in 30 seconds. This was in Barcelona. They used to have a complaint that people are getting asthma attack in a particular area. They were not very clear, why it was happening. And then they started collecting the data. What they did is they actually gave the people a nebulizer with a Bluetooth-enabled nebulizers. So whenever people are taking the nebulizer, using the nebulizer, they used to collect that data. And they found out the pattern, who is taking, when they are taking, and where are they located. And then they started looking at, normally it is related to weather, they started looking at the weather. And they saw that the wind was blowing in one particular direction. And then they looked at what is it coming from. They looked at a shipyard, it was coming from a shipyard. And then they studied what's happening in the shipyard. There they were unloading soya beans. So whenever they were unloading soya beans, people in that particular area used to get the asthma attacks. So what they did is, going forward, whenever they are unloading soya beans, they automatically send out message to all these people, please stay indoors, because next 2 hours, soybeans is going to get unloaded, and you are going to get asthma attack if you are out. So these are very simple things. IoT is going to change the whole new way of living, what we are experiencing today. So that's it. And one last thing is, we as a company, we build, other than the Gecko, which is well known otherwise, we build beacons, and we have already quite a few success stories. We have now solutions which have been implemented in right from a furniture company to a retail outlet, and also in home automation kind of experiences. So we have our beacons, and then we have a complete platform which we can offer. I just wanted to mention about that.
Thank you. Thank you, Bahubali. Yeah. Thank you. And I think Bahubali brings up some good points. When I was listening to the soybeans example, and this is something that Alok from Cisco also mentioned earlier, it's all about understanding the application. You know, for those of you who are entrepreneurs in the IoT space, it's all about understanding the customer and the application. You know, you're not in the IoT business. You are in the business of that particular application. Let me just take one question from the audience. I know Bahubali will be around for a few minutes, and we could follow through the other questions offline. I see a hand over there. Please go ahead. Yeah.
Hi, Bahubali. Just yeah. One thing. I mean, you have been like touching all the point. Don't sure. You think there will be a threat on the privacy maintained by an individual? Because it's like professional and personal. When I get into a store, I get to know that, you know, eggs is running short. I'm a veg. So how do you maintain? I mean, don't you foresee a threat like, you know, maintaining individual personal details between different customers? I mean, as you grow. And one more thing, I mean, I saw this very interesting slide of yours, which is like flicking up, where the husband beeps and, you know, that part. I mean, there are a lot of sensitive data, et cetera. So maintaining such things, how do you see it coming up in the future? And
I would be wrong if I say there are no security threats in this. You know, there are definitely security threats. I mean, we are as vulnerable as we are today. We are already on Facebook. We are putting so many of our personal information. We are already on Twitter. We are telling where we are, what we are doing. I mean, we are as vulnerable as we are today. And it's only that, you know, there is some additional sensor data which is making this thing meaningful, that's all. Security is definitely a different aspect which has to be dealt with. And it's something, a subject which we need to deal with in any case. That we are already on internet. We are already, you know, putting a lot of things on the internet. We are doing, you know, right from your e-shopping to, you know, banking and everything we are doing. Most vulnerable things, we are already on the internet. I mean, we are already exposed. So whatever threat is there, it's already there. So I don't see anything new threat coming because of the IoT just per se.
Thank you.
The only point that
we're
trying to
take this offline if we could.
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bahubali. And Bahubali, just stay on the stage for a second. As a token of appreciation, I'd like to offer this gift. Thank you, Bahubali.
Thank